Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining me today. I am your host, Lori Anderson. Today's date is May 2nd, 2021. I'm going to report to you out of the U.S. Department of Justice, released on Friday, April 23rd, 2021, that the final four have been sentenced in the $189 million healthcare fraud scam. The acting U.S. attorney, Jennifer Lowery, stated that four executives of Continuum Healthcare and its various health centers have been ordered to federal prison for a massive scam perpetrated in the Houston area. And the names of them are the following: Bobby Roos, Stephen Houseworth. Both of those individuals are from Houston. Jeffrey Parsons, David Edison. They have all pled guilty to their respective roles in the scam. Therefore, that is the reason why I'm not saying alleged, because they have already pled guilty to their roles in this scam. On April 22nd, the U.S. District Judge Gary Miller sentenced Riles to 120 months in prison. Edison received a 48-month term of imprisonment, while Parsons and Houseworth each received 30 months in prison. Rouse, Houseworth, Edison, and Parsons were part of the executive team for Continuum Healthcare, LLC, which owned Westbury Community Hospital in Houston, as well as community mental health centers in the Houston area, known by their locations as Hornwood, Baytown, and Missouri City. Each location operated a partial hospitalization program, which is known as a PHP. The PHP was supposed to be a treatment program for individuals with mental illness, intended to closely resemble a highly structured short-term hospital inpatient program. However, while it was a distinct and organized intensive treatment program, it offered less than 24-hour daily care. In 2010, Continuum opened Westbury Community Hospital, with Hornwood and Baytown becoming outpatient centers and continuing to operate their existing PHPs under the Westbury name. Westbury also opened a PHP. The four men were responsible for the day-to-day operation of Continuum Westbury and were involved in the implementation of the various kickback programs. Numerous people were referred for treatment in exchange for payment. However, the vast majority did not qualify for PHP services because they were not experiencing an acute psychotic episode or were actually suffering from mental retardation, dementia, or Alzheimer's. In total, Continuum billed Medicare approximately $189 million in total for fraudulent PHP services, and Medicaid paid approximately $66 million on those claims. So if you are not aware, there are other individuals who have already been charged in that is relative to this case. There were 14 other convictions and 14 other individuals who were charged in the case in 2019. So dating back October 30th, 2019, there was a plea of an 80-year-old Houston man. All 14 charged in the scam involving Continuum Healthcare and its various healthcare centers have been convicted, announced the U.S. Attorney Ryan Patrick. Bob Rouse admitted to conspiring to pay and receive kickbacks and to money laundering related to the Medicare program today. The individuals' names are right here. I'm not going to go through those. I will leave links in the description box below. Rouse, Hornsworth, Edison, and Parsons were part of the executive team for Continuum Healthcare, LLC, which owned Westbury Community Hospital in Houston, as well as a community mental health centers in Houston area known by their locations, Hornwood, Baytown, and Missouri City. During his plea, Rouse admitted to participating in a kickback scheme to pay co-defendants to bring patients to Continuum. He admitted to causing Medicare to pay $18.8 million based on false and fraudulent claims. Each location operated a partial hospitalization group, and the partial hospitalization program was supposed to be a treatment program for individuals with mental illness. It was intended to closely resemble a highly structured short-term hospital inpatient program. However, while it was a distinct and organized intensive treatment program, it offered less than 24-hour daily care. Rose Holsworth, Edison, and Parsons were responsible for the day-to-day operation of Continuum Westbury and were involved in the implementation of various kickback programs. Numerous people were referred for treatment in exchange for payment. However, the vast majority did not qualify for the PHP services. In total, Continuum billed Medicare approximately $189 million for fraudulent PHP services, and Medicaid paid approximately $66 million on those claims. The U.S. District Judge Gray Miller accepted the plea and has set sentencing for January 23, 2020, at which time Rouse faces up to 10 years in prison and a possible $250,000 maximum fine. Rouse was permitted to remain on bond pending that hearing. More and more, you are seeing the medical tyranny. And the medical tyranny tends to come from because they're getting kickbacks. And this is just one case, right? Where they're getting kickbacks because they get to get money from the federal government. And they're like, well, if we do this, then we can get kickbacks and we can make tons of money off of this. And it doesn't matter if what we're doing is right or wrong. And they think that they are immune from being prosecuted on this. People are being held accountable, even if it's not being reported. Tell me what you think in the description box below. Are you glad that they got caught? Do you think we should think twice before we put all our eggs in one basket and trusting these doctors and these nurses? Should we research and see where their funding is coming from? Do you think maybe it would be a good idea if the federal government didn't fund any of the doctors in the first place? Because that would help with the conflict of interest, would it not? Maybe they would actually be doing it to do their job instead of trying to fictitiously do their job, getting kickbacks to get paid by the federal government. The corruption is real. The corruption exists. And yes, we are going after the corruption. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed my report. I will be reporting on a couple more things later this evening. If you would, give me a thumbs up. Follow me, letting you know that I will be on Rumble soon, as well as when Frank opens up, Frank's speech, I will also be on that. When I do, then there will be some changes in the YouTube channel. Until next time, watch your backs, check your facts, Semper Fidelis, and have a wonderful evening.